Hi Pradipa. So before starting, I want to know the difference between like technical business analyst and functional business analyst. Means what difference in real job scenario will be?
Functional business and in the sense like, did you get any requirement?
No. I mean to say, just I want to make sure like what responsibilities will be there for a technical business analyst. Means like where he'll be not involved in like domain knowledge, domain perspective, or how come it will be?
Okay. Yeah. So yeah, let me what I'll do is let me complete the session and then
Okay.
at the end I can tell you, okay? Because I just we have only today's session and then one more session. I have to complete the syllabus. Let me complete that and maybe last 15 minutes I can tell.
Okay, then.
Okay. So hi everyone, thanks for joining. In today's class, today is day 9 and we are going to learn about how to create test plan and test scenarios. Do really like business analysts do have to do these kind of testing? So as we know earlier, right, in last class we saw that how this open EMR application, like how we have to like create different modules and then how we have to write user stories for each modules and all that. So usually BAs are not required to do the testing, but on site, right, we have a requirement to test, but usually UAT we have to do because SIT, maybe SIT is system integration testing, so that you may have a QA team and all who will be doing the testing for you guys. But UAT, right, user acceptance testing, that is the end-to-end testing that's called as UAT. That's with the business owners. So once the code is in QA region, now like you want to test with the business owners because they are the ones who gave you requirements. So basically, you're going to tell, give them like test plans and test scenarios. Okay, so for this application, this is how you need to test. So I'm going to give you a real world testing template. This is for the company Medfusion. Okay, Medfusion's patient portal, and what they are doing is they're going to test the member portal. Member portal means the patient, right, they can log in and they can see their results, lab results, and everything. So if you see, this is a 11-page document. What they are telling us, general information, what is the product, what is the version, and this is the testing URL. So if I click here, it is going to take to Next Gen's page. Okay, Next Gen is a company, and it is going to like tell all the version and everything. So, but I'll show the template is very important now. So what you will do is like you have to create this template, and you have to, for UAT also I'm telling, okay, this is not for SIT, even for UAT region you have to create the template because they don't know how to test, and you have to create these documents and share it with them. And so you're going to tell like how are we going to test and what is the measurable metric. Okay, so how we can say whether it's a pass or a fail. So pass means like they must be able to use the link and they must be able to add all the real-time data and also, but these are not dummy data only. These are not real, means it's not the production data. These are like UAT test data, and you have to like coordinate with the testing team and make sure that member IDs are valid in the UAT region. Once they click on that URL, right, UAT URL, and start testing, that member ID all should be like available in the UAT region. So that coordination that you have to do, creating test members in UAT region and then making sure all the test data is available. For example, they need a email ID. That a dummy email ID should be available for them to be tested. So all kind of testing based upon the scenario, that data should be available in the UAT region. Otherwise, they cannot test. So it is not production data. So always never give production real-time data to the UAT members. I mean, the business owners, you have to specifically create all the test data for them. And either that depends upon the team, right? Whether you have to create all the test members or you have a testing team like the QA team, they can create data for you and all. So, but this document you have to create. Okay, how are they going to log in? How they are going to test the portal team? For example, like a lab report should be available. So what kind of lab report should be there, and what kind of wordings needs to be there, and is it according to their expectations? So for example, a diagnostic image report needs to be there. That needs to be a dummy, like PDF needs to be attached there, so that they will be like, you cannot. Or if you have tested like documents like X-rays and CT scan reports or something like that, that also you can attach, but they need to be test, not real-time X-rays or CTs. So first you have to like develop this test plan document, and then you have to like make sure that what are the exact scenarios that they have to test, and you are giving them, okay, this is the plan. And this is what you have to test, and you are going to like get the sign off and all. What's the email ID? Who needs to complete this and all? You're giving the date and all, and you're giving. Now, how they will record it as pass or fail, for that you have a Excel sheet. So this is the Excel sheet. Okay, so this I got it from a smart sheet, but you can create your own Excel sheet also. But if you are new, you don't know how to create. You can always like download it from Smartsheet. They have very different templates for this testing, and all for manual automation, UAT. Like for every testing, they have that like format. So what you're going to do is, what is the type of test you're going to do? What's the priority, and what's the test date, and how they're going to test, in what environment they're going to test, and you're going to like give them like exactly steps. Okay, so all this and all you can fill. Step one, okay, the user needs to as a new user, I must be able to register and create a username and password. Okay. Once they do that, the next scenario, next test scenario is, as an existing user, I must be able to log in and view the patient portal. Patient portal's dashboard. Okay, I must be able to view the dashboard. Okay, and then and the third one is, once I'm into the patient portal, now as an existing user, I must be able to see my upcoming doctor appointments. Okay, so like this, like every scenario, you have to list down all the scenarios, when they're going to test, expected results, actual results. Expected is, for example, user and a password needs to be created. So you have a username and a password. And you can also add screenshots if you want, right? Expected results, like how it has to, like I can show you how that screenshots would be. Okay. So here, like for example, here they have given like example, like how that screenshot needs to be there, right? Like this, you can take screenshots. So this one, I can put this link in the chat. Here they tell you what is functional testing, how to write a test case scenarios, and then performance testing, how to write, and then security testing, how to write, and all like what are the different types of testing. All this they have added here, so maybe I can put it in the chat so you can take a look when you have time. So, what you do is like what I'm trying to tell is like you create everything, and what they have to do is just like make sure they follow the steps. Okay, step one, this is what I have to do. Step two, this is what I have to do. And then if they are not seeing the ex expected results, if they're able to see the same, then it's a pass. Okay. And but if they're not able to see, it's a fail. And they're going to write notes why it's a fail. Okay, unable to see the dashboard. Unable to view the dashboard like this. So all the scenarios, what you are going to end to end everything, like you cannot test with them. Okay, they have to do the testing. UAT, you cannot test them. You cannot test by yours. SAT, you can test, but UAT, a business owner has to test, and they have to provide the sign off. Okay, they have to say whether it's a pass or a fail. If it's a fail, means that is called a defect. So you have to again go to Jira, ask them to raise a defect, or you can also raise a defect for them, and then like make sure that defect is fixed. For example, this like patient portal dashboard, they're unable to view. So only if they're able to view, other everything will be a pass. If they're unable to view, then that will be a defect. They're raising a UAT defect in Jira. So then you have to like assign that to the developer. Make sure like whatever is a problem that needs to be fixed, again they will start testing. So finally, like once all the testing is a pass, only then they are going to provide the sign off. Okay, until then they are never going to give you the sign off. You should also not get the sign off. So it's very important that you create all these documents for like your end-to-end testing. And in the interview, like they're like Arvind is asking, right, what's the difference between functional business analyst and technical business analyst? Technical business analyst means you have to know in and out technically, like what is the API that we are going to test, how to test an API, like that, and all I will tell you in detail. But technical business analyst means everything about technically what is happening inside the application, and you need to know what kind of testing scenarios will be coming, everything, and there'll be no QA team. You will be the QA, you will be the BA, you will also be the QA, and you will also like all technical documents you only have to create. So developer, he will develop and he will do his side of testing. That is called as unit testing. But other than that, right, you have to know what is API. Like what is SOAP API? What are the two different types of API? SOAP API, REST API. Why we are using API instead of batch processing? And you have to know at least one of, if you're going to use automated tools for testing, then I have to know Selenium. Selenium means that is Java based. So that means in that case, you need to know Java. So functional business analysts, in the sense, they will know only domain knowledge skills. Domain knowledge means you know healthcare, you know property and casualty, and you know like banking, like specific software you know to do. But overall, like you will not know other aspects. Like for example, like these are too technical, right? Selenium means you have like Java, like high-end Java, you need to know. You need to know a little bit of coding. And Pega also, a little bit of like how Pega applications are being created, how to test in Pega. Salesforce also, you need to know end-to-end Salesforce, what is happening. Those are technical BAs. And you can always say a system analyst also, technical system analyst and all. But the pay for them is very high. But this is like, you have to build the resume. Give me a second. So you have, at least if you're not a, if you're very, very new to BA and you're from a non-IT background, it's very hard for you to grasp all the concepts. Then my recommendation is like, please go like, take baby steps, learn one by one. Okay. First, I'm learning basics of BA, and then I'm learning, like for example, see here, what are the things you have to do? How to become an expert in business analysis, and how to make sure your resume is selected. First, you need to learn the basics. Okay, basics in the sense, there are two methodologies. We all know that is waterfall and agile, and what kind of documentation is needed for both the methodologies. If it's waterfall, I'm going to put ad in the resume. I need to know how to create a BRD, FRD, SRS documents. If I'm going to add agile kind of methodology in my resume, which is very popular, that's what they want. You need to know how to create user stories. What is a user? What is the epic? What is a user story? How to write them? What's the format of writing a user story? How to make sure that every user story has story points, and basically all agile terminologies like sprint planning, sprint retrospective, sprint review, all the agile terminologies you need to know. Then you need to know like diagrams, that is mandatory. Like even if you're waterfall or agile, either way you need to know how to draw diagrams. Jira and Confluence, like I told you, these are the tools that you have to learn. Especially if you're adding agile, you need to add Jira and Confluence. So this is our basics. Apart from that, if you're going to become a technical BA or a system analyst, then you need to know how to do this API testing. So there are two type of testing called SOAP testing and REST testing. I will just give you a highlight of what to do. I'll make a separate video. They're very technical. So I will do a separate video on how to do this API testing. But you need to know, like, for example, let me take a scenario, real-time scenario, then you will understand. Okay, now Cigna, this is the member portal of Cigna, right? So for anything, the member has to log in. So, but this is the front end. Now, they want to submit a claim. Okay, they have to log in. Okay, they have to log in here and then they have to submit the claim, right? So when they click on this, they'll be using, all this is member portal. Okay, member portal means member is using this portal. They have to click on that and they have to submit the claims. Okay. But if, do you think they are the same application? They are not the same application. Member portal and claims will not be same application. So let me see, click on claims. Okay. Or maybe how to submit claims. Okay, manage claims and then view claims and submit a claim online, and also you can play your pay your claims. Okay, so for that you have to activate your account and then you need to submit a claim. Here they have said that you have something supplemental, you can submit a claim. Okay, click on that. Okay, now it's taking to a different link. Once you log in, right, this is not the application you're going to see. That will be a separate application. So you may think this has like only one application, but member portal is what is member is facing, but on the back end, right, it is connected to different teams. Okay, now let me take the so front end member facing. Okay, member portal is what like our public is seeing, but as a technical BA, you need to understand that back end, right, from the member portal, okay, it will be connected to claims. Claims application. From there, it will be connected to authorization application. And then from there, it will be connected to appeals application. So everything will be a separate IT team. Okay. Claims will be a separate department and separate IT support will be there. Authorization, separate IT team will be there. Appeal separate will be there. And then, for example, pricing, separate team will be there. Okay, like this, like different, all the back end, right? Different teams will be there. Case management. How they will connect with each team is from member portal, they'll be calling the claims API. Or if the patient is clicking on submit claims, right, what will happen is it's through the API. API means it's kind of link. So if I see here in SOAP testing, right, if you see, you'll be able to. For that, you need to learn what is SOAP and how to test and all. For now, just remember that from For any like SOAP or REST, what we are doing is we are accessing the from, for example, see here, there we are giving a URL, right? So from the member portal's URL, from this URL, there'll be a link, submit the claim. If you click on that, what actually it's doing is it is going to the claims URL, okay? That by using that API, you're actually accessing the claim system and you're submitting or loading the data to the claims database. So that is called as request. So we are sending a request. Request like with valid member ID, because already the member is already logging in through the member portal. So he'll be a valid member. So we have a valid member, and then what he's doing is he's submitting. So we'll be asking the questions. Once we he click on the form, there'll be a questions, right? What is his claim? Whether it's emergency claim, what type of claim it is, medical, dental, vision, what type of claim it is. And so we'll get all the details in that form. Once he clicks submit, what will happen is it is going to the claims department through an API, okay? Just in one click, okay? One member, one click. It is accessing through the claims API, and the data is loaded into the claims database. In once the data is coming to the claims, right, then we do the validation. What validation we are doing? Of course, it will be valid member ID, but anyway, we have to like check with the membership system. So membership system can be like facets or there are many membership systems, right? Like you can have to do the validation, and then we have to write the validation. Okay, our developer has to, when we give that, developer will be coding accordingly. So when we get the members, they have to like check whether we are, it's a valid member. Then we have to check for some kind of keywords. Okay, emergency. Emergency word means it's SLA will be like within 2 hours to 4 hours. So it has to go to two or three queues. Okay. Q in the sense, if it's some word like emergency, urgent, those kind of keywords are there, then the system has to pick that claim and it has to go to a different queue. So the SLA will be like somewhere within 4 hours. And also which market, okay, it will be doing, once we found out the member in membership system, we'll identify which market, right? Whether they're from New York or Florida, depending on market also, the SLA also will be changing. So accordingly, our system has, it has to do at least like 4 to 5 type of validation. First, check the member ID, check which market it is. Then you have to check whether you have emergency words, like very important keywords. If those words are there, then we have to like make sure that is going to a particular queue. Because within that certain queue, the claims has to be approved, or it will have some timelines. Or if it doesn't have any kind of those kind of words, then it will go into the normal queue. And you will send back the response stating that claim is submitted. So that request and response will be immediate, okay? Once the member submits the claim, immediately we will give a response saying that your claims is submitted. Please log in and view for status or progress, something like that. But this validation all will be secondary only. Immediately, the member will get a response saying that your claim is submitted. Immediately, that is like within a second or something, they'll get the response. And REST is even faster. They'll be able to process because there are multiple members, 1.5 million members for one state. At least like every day, you'll have at least like thousands of hits, at least 10,000 hits you'll be having for that particular claims team API. It must be able to like perform and make sure nothing is there is no error and all. So that's where this performance testing, load testing, all this testing is coming, right? So if you are a technical BA, they are going to like ask you so many questions on, okay, have you really worked on any kind of API testing? And do you know how API works from one system to another system? Can you give me an example, like what kind of testing you have done? How, what is SOAP? Why we are using only REST instead of SOAP? What is the difference between SOAP and REST? And tell me an example, because you told you worked, right? Can you please tell me? So you have to be prepared to answer all these kind of questions, and they can, you can get embarrassed if you're on a surface level. If you learn this and you put it, add in your resume, you make it really embarrassed. But if you want to become a technical BA, and if you want to like build your resume, and you don't want to become a vanilla BA, then I would recommend. This is not like rocket science. Anybody can learn. You if you are, if you're able to learn English, and if you're able to communicate in English, anybody can learn SOAP UI. But it will take time. Since you're not from the technical background, it will take time, at least 1 or 2 weeks, and someone has to really know SOAP UI, has to teach you. So I will probably make a video maybe next month or something on this, because this will take at least 4 to 5 videos on, like, first I have to explain about what is rest difference between, then how to test, show you examples and all, how to test and how you can add in your resume. But if you want to build your resume in a more technical way, then you can add all this SOAP and REST. Also tabbed for reporting. So if you want to, if they ask you, like, do you know reporting? Have you created, generated reports and all? Then you can add Tableau. And apart from all this, definitely you need to have domain knowledge. Either it's healthcare or banking, or you can be like property and casualty, whatever it is, like any, that domain knowledge is very, very, very important. Functional business analyst only will know only like domain knowledge. But technical business analyst will be like knowing, like, for example, everything, end-to-end testing, everything they will need to know. Okay, any doubts till now?
No, just one question, Pradeepa. When we talk about testings, basically, as a business system analyst, what testing scenarios we come across? Like, what kind of testings we almost like in a generic we come across? Like, if sometimes they may be API testing or may not be API testing.
Yeah, definitely not API testing, but that end-to-end application, whatever you're gathering requirements, right, that you need to test. Okay, let me take an example of that OpenEMR, okay. Okay, so this is an application that you have gathered requirements. Now you have the link, okay, testing link you have, and you need to test like all these scenarios. As an admin, you need to test. As a physician, you need to test. As a clinician, you need to test. Accountant, you need to test. Receptionist, you need to test. Also, a patient portal, right? That also you need to test. They have given two different links. For portal, they have given different links, and for other credentials, they've given different links. So you have to make sure that the In SIT, if they want you to test, once the developer has completed development, they're moving the code to QA. He will tell you the code is in QA now. Please start testing. And then he'll give the links also. So you have to like make sure that you open and then do all the testing. Like he'll give you all these details. So all this username, password, he will give you. And so what you have to do is you have to log in, and then because you are the one who gathered requirements, so you should know how to test and what is the business owner's requirements, right? For patient portal, how it has to look. For clinicians portal, how it has to look. And accountant means what it has to look. And because you already have the BRD, all the user stories and all that. So you have to find out all the scenarios. You may miss the scenarios also, like I said here. So like this is the document. So write all the use cases, test scenarios, and then like make sure you test in SIT. If you're not getting results, then you put as a fail and send back, create a defect in Jira and ask the developer to fix it. This is an SIT. And in SIT, everything is good. Then only you're asking the business owner to test in UAT. You got the point?
Okay, so
Yeah.
basically after the development is done, the sprint, what within the sprint after the development, we go for the SIT, we check it, and
Right.
then we get back if there is an issue.
Right. You raise any defects and he has to fix it. And then
And
again,
UAT, I'm sorry, yeah.
so when you're in SIT, if you raise a defect, right? So he will again fix it in SIT. Again, you have to test in SIT. Only if everything, all the scenarios are passed in SIT, the code will go to UAT.
Okay, it's after the end of the sprint only, right?
This also needs to happen within that 3 week sprint.
3 weeks sprint to, okay, yeah, okay.
So if you take a user story, that user story needs to be developed, tested, and UAT pass everything within the 3 weeks.
3 weeks, okay.
And so that's why we are taking very small pieces of user stories, okay? Whenever you are not able to test a user story, then you have to split that. If it's a very big functionality, but like for example here, we cannot test the patient portal in one sprint here. Or I need to have 2 to 3 developers to test every functionality, or the sprint needs to be at least like 4 week sprint or something to test everything. In 2 week sprint, I cannot complete all the testing. right? In 2 weeks, he cannot develop everything and I cannot test everything. That is not reasonable. So for this functionality, for this kind of testing, at least it will take 4 week sprint to test. And then if there is any bugs, again, it's going to like, we are going to expand, right? We are going to like make sure, for example, in a particular sprint within 4 weeks, you are not able to complete UAT. Then you need to postpone that. And then that's why during estimation is very, very crucial. Like you need to know if for one user story, how long it will take to like test. I always give extra points. Don't give like, if it is, you think this is a 5-pointer, please give it as 8-pointer. Or if you think this is a 3-pointer, please give it as a 5-pointer. Because we never know what kind of bugs you will get and you need time to fix that. Okay, so yes, any other questions? Any doubts regarding like what is BA's role in testing? Okay, so my recommendation is like for everyone who wants to become a BA, please take things slowly, and this all can be very overwhelming for you. Like when I tell like you have to learn this, you'll be like, oh my god, there's too much to learn. But you need to understand you're not learning coding. Okay, you're not learning, this is not coding at all. Except when you are, if you're going to go for Selenium testing, then only then you need to learn about this Java and all. Otherwise, you're not learning any kind of coding. And you will be able to learn. And even though this may look like simple, in reality, we are finding it very hard to get a technical business analyst because not everybody knows what other... In public, right, in general public, like academies, what they are teaching is like, they are teaching only the basics of BA. What is BA? What is waterfall? How to create BA? That's all. To that level, only in the market, people are teaching. But they are not teaching exactly how to do these kind of testing or how to, in a project from end to end, what a BA has to test and all, and where it's very easily... We can, in the interview, we'll be able to figure out if we are getting trained in like 10 days or 15 days, we can easily like figure it out. They don't have like that depth of knowledge in anything. So don't be shallow. If you take anything, you can become, if you take Pega, please learn Pega properly. If you are going to become a Salesforce BA, please learn Salesforce properly. And after some time, right, your mind will capture, it will be able to identify, okay, this is how we have to test. So please take multiple case studies and you have to like write documents. And then this testing also, there are like n number of free tools in Google. So please do your research and start learning the concepts one by one. And otherwise, it's very hard for your resume to get picked up. It's very competitive even in India too. So just by writing like I know waterfall agile, your resume is not going to pick up, right? So if you want to enter into Fortune 400 companies or maybe product based, especially product based, right, like Amazon and Amazon, definitely they want you to know all this testing. Just plain vanilla BA, they can hire any American. Okay, so please learn one of these languages like Pega or Salesforce, and then one of the testing, okay, not so. So, and one more thing, if they ask you, do you know SOAP or REST, don't tell that in one project, just write SOAP and another project, write REST. Otherwise, they'll be asking, so you had two APIs, like why do you have SOAP and REST? So you may say that SOAP was very slow, then we upgraded to REST. But if you don't have enough knowledge about API, please choose just only one. SOAP is easy than REST. REST is actually very faster. So just learn the basics and then add just one in your resume. Or maybe in one project, add SOAP, and in another project, you can add REST. Don't add both in the same project. If you are going to add in the same project, they may ask you, why did you change from SOAP to REST? So you need to maybe give scenarios and then tell why you changed. Or maybe give some production incidents. And because of SOAP, it was unable to like take so many hits. We had performance issues. And so we wanted to be a little faster. That's why we upgraded to REST. And he's going to ask you so many questions. So be careful when you're adding this kind of testing. Okay, that's it for today. And so for like next half an hour and for tomorrow session, I'm just like going to like interact with you and then tell you, like give guidance on like if you don't have any questions, you want to discuss your resume or what do you want to do. Like if you have any questions for me, you can ask. So tomorrow will be the last class, but the next half an hour and tomorrow is like 1 hour. It's going to be just interaction. If you have any questions, you can ask.
Pradeepa, I have to want to talk to you actually, Siddharth. With respect to some user stories, if we can have with respect to PNC insurance, you know,
property and
tomorrow.
Casual. Yeah. So you have interview tomorrow, right?
Yes.
You want to do a mock-up now?
No, I'm not ready.
You're not ready. Tomorrow is an interview. You have to be ready.
I mean, I can talk about, but the thing is, I'm like still making myself ready for tomorrow's point of view. Like, what kind of user stories I can pitch in, or if I say I have some experience with that. I mean, you know,
so you can say claims. This property. Let me take up the EAG UI. Okay, I will edit this in YouTube. Okay, this will not be in YouTube. Okay, edit this. So this is AIG. AIG is property and casualty. Okay, property and casualty means they do like home insurance and they do auto insurance. If you see their if you see their portal, you will be able to see that there are many kind of worldwide. So let me. So they are in America, they are in Europe, they are in Asia Pacific, they are in Middle East, also in Africa. So they support like 30 to 40 countries around the globe, and everywhere it is called as AIG only. And they are one of the leading property and casualty providers, I mean insurance company. Okay, so this is a front end, Siddharth, and there is a direct link in Pega application here. If you click on claims, okay, and then if you want to submit claims or so if we want to log in, okay, submit a claim, report a claim, something. If you want to log in, right? This is Pega. Hi, do you see the dashboard? It's different.
Yeah.
This is Pega UI, okay? And so you give the username and password again and you log in and it's directly taking to Pega. So this is different. Okay, this website, web portal is different. But when you click on, it will go to, for example, I click here. This is member portal. Just by seeing the UI, you will know. So AIG login is member portal, but if it's claims, right, it's going to report a claim or anything related to a claim, this is going to Pega. Pega application will be front end, will be like this only. Very simple UI will be there. So what it's doing is once you log in, it will ask you for a questionnaire. And that questionnaire, right, will be like, what is the claim? For example, there is an accident. This is property and casualty, right? So maybe you have a car accident and the glass was broken. Take this scenario, okay? So you can say that you work for claims. And that interaction is like from the member portal, directly it will hit the Pega service. And then in Pega modules, you can say that I was working as a BA. So my responsibility is like for auto insurance claim processing. Or any one module you can take, either auto or home, whatever it is. You can take this one module and then you can say, I was working for claims. And once the member, they log into Pega, they'll be able to see a survey, like or maybe a form like claims, and they should be able to add. So you're going to pick up the words, something like emergent, glass broken. Because auto insurance, for example, the car was there in the parking lot, the glass was broken. It in US it is legal to submit that claim, and we have to cover, the AIG have to cover if a glass is broken, even if it's in the parking lot. But they are supporting other countries too, so you can say I